Just how safe is skydiving? A question many are asking after two small planes collided in the skies above Wisconsin this past weekend, putting the lives of nearly a dozen people in jeopardy. And could something similar actually happen here? Action News reporter Tom Miller has a closer look. He's live from Hollister.
Dan, clearly there's an inherent risk that goes along with skydiving, but all things considered, fatalities are actually pretty rare. Just 19 in the United States last year, according to the United States Parachute Association. Here at Skydive Hollister, they say that an accident like what happened in Wisconsin could never happen here because, for one, they only fly one plane rather than two.
Looking down from 12,000 feet, this is what you want to see. But for the 9 divers and 2 pilots high above Wisconsin, the overhead view quickly changed as the 2 Cessnas carrying them came together.
First thing I remember thinking is that I need to regain control of this airplane. And I immediately pulled the yoke back to my chest as far as I possibly could. And there was no reaction from the airplane.
The aircraft that was underneath the other airplane had a high wing, so he could not see up. There's no
Skydive Hollister pilot Kevin Moon saw the dramatic footage and says that risk goes along with flying planes so close. Here, just one bigger plane is used, holding up to 17 people.
I mean, it's one thing if you're a military background and or you do some formation flying in the military. That's just for them, pretty much.
Kevin says most accidents are not pilot error, but rather something the diver does wrong. Though rare, it's happened here before. In 2001, a man died in Hollister after slamming into a hillside at 35 miles per hour. And in 2011, a woman in Tres Pinos made a hard turn in the air, causing her to free fall from 40 feet to her death.
The count will be ready, to go.
Despite what could go wrong, first-time jumper Jenna Hope feels confident after a safety talk from her tandem instructor.
So his talk made me feel a little better. He seems really knowledgeable, so that actually calmed me down.
Her plunge from 15,000 feet went exactly to plan. Now back on the ground, she says safety was the least of her concern.
I felt really safe and just kind of like getting my stomach under control.
And even though people here are well aware of what happened in Wisconsin, the owner says it's business as usual. We saw proof of that ourselves. Both of the afternoon jumps were completely full. Dan?
All right, thank you very much, Tom. Coming up tonight on Dateline, the full interview with one of the pilots involved in that collision in Wisconsin, tonight at 8 on KSBW NBC.